This will be a short video.
But useful as always. Well, at least interesting.
The logic tree window in Valve Hammer, or a blueprint for the poor. Let's go! Before we start, I need to explain what a logic tree or a blueprint is in general. If you have ever worked in 3D Max or in the Grid Unreal Engine, you could see how objects were connected to each other by incomprehensible threads. Cheese threads actually symbolize outputs in PostScripts that link parent the child objects inside the project. As you understand, this system was innovated to simplify working with the ledge on complex logical constructions. Something similar exists in the source engine, and specifically inside the Valhammer editor. So behold the simplest example of such a tree. Logic outer turns off the trigger, and trigger in turn interacts with the two lamps, turning them on and off. Once the lamp, using the on user command, turns on a sprite, and the sprite in turn runs a broken command that leads to nothing. As for me, such a view of an entire structure is much more convenient than switching from the entity by another using the mark button. Please note that input commands are always located to the left of the selected objects, and outputs come from the right of it. Broken scripts are marked with a cross. Now a couple of words about how to arrange objects on the screen. Select them, and then select the layout default option. The entities are lined up in a vertical row. The oldest objects are always located at the bottom, and the new ones are at the very top, respectively. If you select the layout block option, the old entities will be located in the lower left corner, and the new ones in the upper right corner. And the last option is layout geometric. Now the entities are located where they are on your map. This type of location is better to be used on large maps only. Look at another useful function. Select the parent, then use Select All Cascading button. Now all objects linked to the parent are also selected. I'm not sure I understand the purpose of the Select All Connected function, but it seems to me that it was supposed to select all objects in the chain, even if we don't choose a parent. If you know more than I do, please leave a comment about it. It seems to be the end of the lesson. Oh yes, you can change the background color from gray to black by simply changing the grid density.
What does the end mean? Aren't you gonna tell us how to turn these features on?
Let them first subscribe to the channel, put a like and give me their money.
Oh, stop it. Friends, this view works in every version of Valve Hammer, but you can enable it quickly in editors for Garry's Mod and Hammer++ only. Therefore, we have prepared for you some dirty hacks. The first one is the registry editor in Windows, hotkey current user, software, Valve, Hammer, Splitter. There are four files with words draw type in their names. These are our four Hammer windows. Select the desired window and enter the number 10. After that, any of editors you have installed have a logical tree rendering enabled by default. Of course, this is not the most convenient way, but you should know about it. The dirty hack number 2. Just use Hammer for Gmod. Select the desired mod, close Hammer and open the editor you need. For example, an editor for CSGO. And the last one, dirty hack. Launch wide and select the Hammer Splitter editor tool. There you specify the necessary settings. One moment and everything is ready. Unfortunately, we did not find the information about hotkey inside Valhammer to enable the mod we need. We hope you'll find this information and share it with us.
Удачи, Tomodachi!